Hello and a warm welcome to this special edition of To The Point. On the show this week, we have a very special personality, someone who's been a scientist, an administrator. He's known as the Missile Man of India. No guesses now, he's the 11th President of India.
Neelu from Rajya Sabha TV.
I welcome Professor A P J Abdul Kalam on the show. Welcome.
Thank
sir.
You for all the Rajya Sabha TV.
It's a pleasure, sir, to have you on the program.
Yeah.
So let me begin by asking you with a book which you wrote, India 2020, in which you advocated plans as to how to make India into a developed nation. So to just get a thought from you. Is India really heading in the right direction as far as its growth story is concerned?
Well, we wrote this, we had a plan, Technology Information Forecasting Council of Department of Science and Technology. We evolved India 2020 vision. And it was I gave a presentation of TIFAC work, what we have done on the technology development towards the national development, the economic development. Mm-hmm. And also I was asked to give a presentation to the cabinet, and we gave a presentation. And the Prime Minister in the Red Fort announced India will become a developed nation by India 2020. The Red Fort Independence Day, he announced also. Now, we were progressing very well up to 1996, 97, 98, 99, you find then the problem started around 2010, right. Some problem across the Atlantic Oceans, right. Both sides, and then we were growing 9% GDP growth was there, right. It crashed to 4.5, something like that, it came down, okay. Now it is, I understand the World Bank says we are about 5.6 GDP growth. Yeah. What we need for economic development, another 5 years there for 2020. Okay. I'm a believer, even 5 years time, the government can push, parliament can push, both Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha can push. A well-prepared document is there, India 2020 vision. We can become an economically developed nation. Only condition is GDP growth should be some, just like what we had in 1990s.
But sir, when we talk about the growth story of India, I mean, for the last one decade, there were too many factors like policy paralysis, people were saying there were too many scams which were coming in the light. Then there were parliamentary disruptions which were happening, due to which policy making was really suffering. Do you think that these were the major factors probably which perhaps pushed India back?
I visualize my parliament, both Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, what they should do, what is called developmental politics.
Okay.
All politicians, 500 plus members are there, both houses. You see, what is politics? Politics equal to development politics plus political politics. Developed politics means a nation's development. In so many years, one party will say, in so many years I will develop India, economically develop. I will remove the poverty. Another part will say, no, I will, 60-70% of the time I can do that.
Right.
That's called development politics. Political politics, how to become the member of a parliament.
Right.
Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha. Now that is naturally one has to do, that's very important. But time taken for a political party should be 30%. 70% for development politics. Unfortunately, in our
this
country,
is not happening.
In our country and other countries, it is happening in different way. That is development politics done by nearly 30% of the time. Their members, my view is, time has come that our parliament members should work for, our parliament should work for that more time on development politics. I visualize 5 sessions of parliament, both houses, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, 5 to 10 meeting exclusively how to develop by 2020 India becoming economically developed nation. There is no other big mission India has got today. Okay, apart from a security mission.
Right. But Professor Kalam, like last year, I mean, with the Anna Hazare movement and all those movements which came up.
I'm not here to talk about the past. Okay, I'm not here to talk about the past, what X done, Y done. It's not my territory. My territory is how to make India is economically developed. Okay, it is possible within the 5 years if we grow GDP to from present about 6% GDP growth to 10%, 9.5 to 10%. It is possible. It is possible because country has got a potential industry, service sector, and agriculture sector. It has got a potential to do that, and we have to converge. Okay, I will do this job. Parliament has to debate continuously 1 month on that. No other subject must do it. Exclusive parliament meeting should be there in your Rajya Sabha, in our Lok Sabha.
Absolutely. And but perhaps, sir, many times.
Don't take me to the politics side.
No. But many times it happens that the leaders increasingly start using disruption as a means of parliamentary intervention.
I see. That's why I said, I am telling the past thing, you are putting me in the negative side. Past thing is, they must spend 1 month time in developmental politics.
Okay,
that's what I'm saying. That is the point we should go to our parliamentarian. Let us spend how to make India 2020 possible in remaining 5 years time. Can we make? Definitely it is possible.
But as far as policy making is concerned, to goad the development politics, what you're talking about, what are the key drivers which perhaps the bureaucrats and the leaders need to think at this point of time?
See, I have a feeling it's very clear. There are 5 areas we have given the highest priority. Okay. Parliament is aware of it. The number one, agriculture, agro-food processing. Okay. Our farmers doing exceedingly well. They produce 250 to 260 million tons every year. But value addition very important. Okay. So we should converge how to do the value addition so the economy will grow because of the value addition. 5 to 10 times it will grow, and also it will benefit the farmers.
Right.
Okay, that's number one. Number two, industrial sector. Okay, number three, education and health care. Because education and health care very important, because women health, women education, the immediately small families are born, right. Women education. Similarly, I have talked about infrastructure development. And then critical technology. These are the 5 areas. The idea identified in the book India 2020 Vision, all the 5 areas have been identified, okay?
But Professor Kalam, in one of your books, India Manifest, you also batted for e-elections. Yes. Is that really possible? Because the political, there's a need for a political will for that to happen. But how really, what kind of a reality check is it really?
See, I personally believe now average, last few general election we say, we are graduating 50 to 60%. 60% of people vote. So maximum 65%. It is possible, it's growing. Maximum we can go 70%. Whatever you do, 70%. But I believe the e-election comes in. Nowadays mobile, you have, I have, he has got, every one of us has got mobile. And also there's a code. It cannot be broken. Because code is changing quite often. So it cannot be broken. So once code is unbreakable code, and since mobiles, every Indian is going to, almost having 90% Indians having, it's very easy. It's possible to do that. Possible to do that. Then you will fight minimum 90% of the voting.
But sir, with the kind of bureaucratic lethargy which normally sets in the government and which is there, of course, there's no doubt about it. Do you think that is really possible and the political leaders will start thinking on those lines?
See, I have a feeling this political system, they must decide, number one, I am going for development politics. They are the leaders. Okay, development politics. Once leaders decide development politics, the whole system of management, system of administration will have to change. Will have to change. People started coming at 9 o'clock to the office now.
Right.
How it happened?
So the cultural change also sets in, you're talking about. So of late, we've seen that too many ordinances have come in.
No, I am going to talk to you about the innovation now. Innovation. Today, I have come for innovation.
No, no, you were talking about Parliament, so which is why I started talking about that. But sir, country is also on the verge of finalizing an innovation policy. We have a draft bill which is there on the website of the Department of Industrial Policy and Planning. And they have invited suggestions from various stakeholders. What is the key point which probably the bureaucrats in the country needs to bring to the forefront when they are devising the innovation policy of the country?
See, innovation of a nation is born out of a creativity. Creativity is born out of excellence.
Okay.
Performance, excellence of every individual. So you will find innovation, creativity, excellence in mind, thinking and action, all the three are interconnected. Now for a nation, a prosperous nation, happy nation, is powered by technology. Technology is powered by innovation. So I believe innovation very important. It should become our policy. And we have to recognize innovation is there. Just now I saw innovation has come from a teacher, a village teacher. He has got a website.
Right.
In that innovation website, he has connected hundreds of teachers. Okay. He gives contents. What is the content? What the unique questions students ask, teachers ask, all these put it in there. That's a fantastic innovation I saw.
Right.
Yeah, teacher. Another one I saw, the biogasifier. That has also come to the rural area. And another innovation I saw, the old people, when they are climbing the walker.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing, and the collapsible leg is there, collapsible telescopic leg is there. So these are all great innovation has come out of the rural area.
But Professor Kalam, if innovation and learning always go together, but this is not happening in India, at least at the pre-primary level, you still have the system of rote learning where children are cramming things, where children are cramming all the knowledge. But they are not encouraged so much for innovation. How can it really start at the school level?
See, this National Innovation Foundation, so they are recognizing every year 100 innovators, 110 innovators, and from various parts of the country. It may be village, they visit the villages, find out who are the innovators. It may be fishermen folk, it may be farmer folk, it may be a laboratory, it may be high-tech institution. Everywhere they are finding the innovators. So that route is very good. Now your policy, national policy we need, but how much you should commit for innovation, how much money we should allot for innovation, encouraging the innovation. The highest experience will come from the institution like the National Foundation, because they have got, they are the custodian of the knowledge now. That's my feeling.
But sir, do you feel that there is a need for integrating the innovation? Because like in India, you have a segregated policy. It's a grassroots innovation. Then you have other innovations happening. So do we need to integrate innovation?
No, if you get to do it, then problem will come. Okay. The who is big, who is small, that's not the issue. Innovation is the only thing. It can come from grassroots, it can be any route it can come. But grassroots, one of the examples. But you will find innovation coming also. See, laboratory, it comes from farmers, it comes from fishermen, it comes from teachers, it comes anywhere. We saw that in that.
Right.
If you see the exhibition hall, you see the innovation has come from everywhere.
It's always so insightful to hear from you, Professor Kalam, but I'll have to take a break here. We'll come back with lots more on the other side. Back in a moment.
Rabindranath Tagore was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913 for his book Gitanjali. In 1950, he composed the music and lyrics for India's national anthem, Jana Gana Mana. And when Bangladesh became independent in 1971, they chose Tagore's song, Amar Shonar Bangla, as its national anthem. Tagore's life and works have made him a cultural icon, studied the world over, even into the 21st century.
दुनिया का हाल, राजनीति की चाल, बिजनेस की रफ्तार, खेल का धमाल, दिन की शुरुआत खबरों के साथ। देखिए हर रोज सुबह 9 बजे सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर।
साइना नेहवाल, द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू विन अ मेडल इन बैडमिंटन एट द ओलंपिक्स, द वर्ल्ड नंबर 2 रैंक प्लेयर इज आल्सो द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू विन द वर्ल्ड जूनियर बैडमिंटन चैंपियनशिप्स एंड द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू विन अ सुपर सीरीज टूर्नामेंट। Saina Nehwal in fact completed a hat-trick Super Series titles in 2010. That same year, she became the first Indian singles player to reach the final of the year-ending Super Series finals, defeating two-time All England champion and former world number one Tine Baun in the semis.
आवाज में रूहानियत, खुशमिजाज शख्सियत,
हमको नशा है भारत का होने का ही,
कबीराना अंदाज, संघर्ष की एक लंबी दास्तान।
मैं चातक की तरह जीता हूँ, मैंने भूख को हराया है कितनी बार।
अल्लाह के बंदे,
मिलिए शख्सियत में मशहूर मारूफ कलाकार कैलाश खेर से सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर।
As science beckons India into the future, Rajyasabha Television partakes the responsibility, bringing technology to the Indian people.
Let's take a look at various important science events in the country,
monitoring scientific advances as they unravel.
Intergovernmental panel on climate change has proposed a complete ban on fossil fuels.
Welcome to Eureka.
Interviewing the country's greatest minds. Project the power of science to benefit and transform India. Rajya Sabha Television, Democracy at Work.
Welcome back. You're watching To The Point with Professor APJ Abdul Kalam. So despite all the innovations which are happening, we've seen that India has not been performing very well as far as the innovation index is concerned. Even in the global competitive index, India is not doing too well.
India is not doing well. I agree with you.
What is the reason according to you?
Reason is the competitiveness. No, it is like this. Yeah, economic development is powered by competitiveness. Competitiveness is powered by knowledge. Knowledge is powered by technology, and technology is powered by innovation. This is the cycle. Innovation, you need resource to prosper.
Right.
You need resource. So finally, the root is the national economic development. You come into innovation, very important. Innovation to grow, you need money. Resources.
But sir, don't you agree
resource, that's why a parliamentary policy should come in a big way.
But sir, don't you think that the parameters on which the indexing is done, the indexing of innovation is done, perhaps in countries like US or European countries, and those parameters are very different from the ones which are followed?
Yeah, it has to be different because we are quite different. Reason is.
But sir, do you feel that time is ripe now for India to start its own parameters on which the indexing capacity should be judged?
See, for example, we are in the competition index, in the economic development index, we are more than 60. Okay, we should come within 10, within 10.
Okay.
If you have to 10, if in within the 10 we have to come, we have to empower our farmers produce more, our service sector produce more, our industry produce more, and also that value addition, higher value addition should be there.
Right.
That is, technology should help them value addition, so the earning capacity increases.
Right.
Then you will find our competition index from 62, it will go to 5, 10, 10.
Right.
Our aim should be within 10 we should be there. That means a developed world, we should become a developed world.
But sir, I'll just take you a little off track. Of course, I'm not going to ask you anything very political, but you did make a statement when this Anna Hazare movement was on, that, you know, this kind of a revolution is needed when a certain change has to be brought in the society. Do you think, I'm not going into the deeper thoughts of those movements as to what happened and, you know, what really panned out of that, but do you really think that that revolution was a kind of a watershed moment for Indian politics? Do you really feel that?
See, what, according to me, we need a movement.
Okay.
The greatest movement should come to this country is definition change of the politics.
Okay.
Politics equal to development politics plus political politics. And our politicians, full politicians should spend, leaders should spend 70% of the parliament members or assembly members on economic development of the state, economic development of the center. 30% they should send political politics. Now reverse taking place. 70% they spend, they get locked on to.
But so with the new Narendra Modi government, they are harping more on development and coming out with missions like Swachh Bharat, then smart cities. Do you think that with the Narendra Modi government, maybe the country is on the right track?
I can give only the vision. The vision is, you do 70%, how I can develop my state?
Right.
State politicians should think of.
Right.
Center should think of how I can develop the whole country.
Right.
70% like economic development. Country will get only economic development, not politics.
Right.
Political party is essential because they have to be elected to the parliament or legislative assembly or panchayat board member. Okay? The manifesto for change, I have written a book on that.
Right.
Manifesto for
right.
change. You read it, ask me questions. Okay?
But on a lighter tone, if Mr. Kalam is given an opportunity to fight a presidential election, would you do that?
No, I am very happy at teaching now. I teach here in IIM.
Okay. So you keep giving speeches to the students?
Yeah, teaching and research is my focus.
But what about addressing a political rally maybe?
No, politically I am not interested. My interest so far, I have met 19 million youth.
Right.
Last two decades.
Right.
Youth directly I have met them. Every month I meet 100,000 people, in a year million people. Okay. So, I am in contact with youth. I know their dreams, their
In fact,
pain.
You have a movement called What Can I Give movement, which is based on corruption and those things.
No,
to fight out corruption.
What can I give is the opposite of what can I take.
Okay.
What can I take? What is the movement? You answered me. What can I take?
No, what can I give movement?
No, what can I take? Opposite of what can I give is what can I take.
Take, yeah.
What does it mean, what can I take? Means corruption starts.
Okay, but I have taken a lot from you from this interview. This much I
so
know.
What can I give? That's why I started, what can I give?
Right.
There is nothing to do with anything else except always I don't need money to give, you know. What are you giving a smile, do you need a money?
Oh, absolutely not.
No. So that's the thing.
It was a pleasure talking to you, Professor Kalam.
Thank you. God bless you to Rajya Sabha TVRs.